right? 8-1-3 games with 10 on the list. Much better situation than the other day. Wow, I think that guy's deaf. You hear how loud he's talking? It's early and peaceful out here. Calm that shit down. Got that early morning thing going today. 11:03 a.m. What? We're getting out of here. Let's go. Got that morning Las Vegas Strip action going on a Tuesday. What? Let's head over to the Venetian, where all the high hand action is. Really probably where all the action is, just period, on a Tuesday late morning, early afternoon. Waking up at 6 a.m. again today, and then having leftover ribeye from the cast iron skillet last night. It was a pretty tasty breakfast. It was an even more tasty dinner last night. Standard operating procedure for playing at Venetian at this hour would be to park at Treasure Island and then hit Starbucks and go over, but I decided to park at Wynn so I could swing by the Fashion Show Mall Starbucks, save a couple of dollars, like literally $2 for a regular coffee saved, right? Plus it gives me a few extra steps, get to breathe in a little of that Vegas Strip action for a few more minutes. Yeah, oh, the Wynn. Sometimes I forget that I have stars on my Starbucks account. It only takes 50 stars to get a free coffee, like a regular brewed coffee, which is all I want anyway. So there you go, freebie. Let's get on it. I would call my game halfway decent, like right at the 50% decent mark. Like not 100% decent, definitely not more than that. And not less than, not like 43% decent, like 50, it's like halfway decent. You know what I can always use? More coffee. It's just like all, it's like always, right? And I don't mean the sanitary pad. I'm talking about, what, trooper? What you talking about? Over here to Bally's because somebody wants to get some coffee from me, and hey, coffee is like an emergency situation. If somebody needs coffee, it's kind of like the Batman type shit. You throw the signal up and I'm bringing the coffee, right? I ended up winning at Venetian $279, and where does that put me for the year? $499, up $499 for the year, I believe. By the way, I hope you caught, why do I hear all this beeping action and ain't no doors opening? I hope you caught in the last vlog that I said I won $159, but I really won $158. Because I forgot I tipped the cashier.
Here with the trooper, get some coffee.
Get some coffee. Jesse and
Florian.
Been watching him since he was in Florida.
Oh yeah.
Been following him along. Great guy.
Yo, thanks Jesse for getting the coffee to take back to Chicago. Man, it's a nice day out here. Taking the outside route back to the car. So speaking of Go Gamble, Go Gamble is about to get an overhaul. I'm about to get for Go Gamble what I should have gotten a long time ago, what Go Gamble has been missing for a long time, and that is design. I feel like, well, first of all, I've said a thousand times, I'm not an artist or a designer. I can barely draw a stick figure, but I'm actually working with a designer right now to help me with some cool t-shirts. So I don't have anything to show you yet, but hopefully I soon will. And I hope that they turn out, they gotta be at least 100 times better than what I can do. Go Gamble as a brand deserves to have quality design. I guess now I'm gonna head back to the old Casa del Trooper. Christina wasn't feeling too hot today, so she decided not to venture out. I think I'm gonna head back and figure out what we're gonna have for dinner. That steak from hours ago is wearing off quick. Part of me is feeling a little tired from waking up at 6 a.m. Another part of me wants to jump into another game. You know how it is. When you're winning, it's a lot easier to be motivated to play more. But I told Lady Trooper I'm on the way home, so I think I'm gonna head home, get some food. Tomorrow's Wednesday. I will likely be back out here at it again.